1866, in the territory of Arizona, a treaty existed between the Mescalero Apaches and the United States government. As was the case of many treaties with the Indians, this one was broken. The question of which side first broke the treaty is still disputed today. It is known, however, that the head of one band of Apaches would not necessarily feel obligated to honor the decisions of the leader of another band. On May 16th, a troop of cavalrymen, under the leadership of an ambitious young lieutenant, attacked and massacred a sleeping camp of Mescalero men, women, and children. The leader of that Apache band, along with his woman, were among the few survivors. Ironically, he and his people had believed in and were respecting the treaty. That once peaceful man who had opposed killing now became a feared and hated warrior. He soon came to be known to white men throughout the territory as She Klitso, the man who wore the yellow shirt.
Thank you. I knew the fellow who lost a couple of fingers that way.
I just can't wait no longer. That wasn't thunder you heard a while ago. That was my big gut tearing up my little one, and I'm a-fixing to head it off before it gets to my backbone.
Boy, Ricky, we better pitch in, fellas. The rate limb's going, we ain't gonna have nothing left.
Ain't you grubbing tonight, Major? Seems to me you'd get enough of that writing just making out them survey maps in the daytime.
Give us a start. We didn't expect you back so soon.
Had a change of plans, Major. Sort of figured you'd be more interested in this than camp meet.
Little bit of yellow shirt's handiwork.
I'd hope that renegade had learned his lesson after the skirmish we had at the Big Muddy last spring.
Wolves don't change, Major, once they've tasted blood.
Were there any others with this man?
Near as I could tell, there wasn't. He was a dispatcher from Fort Blanding. I found this on him. It's made out to you, sir.
The treaty with the Mescaleros has been broken. Yellow Shirt and his band have ambushed the supply train from Fort Haines and butchered all troops. You are hereby ordered to return to the safety of the fort immediately. Signed, Colonel Redding.
Men, we're going to break camp in the morning. Private Hatfield, see to the bearing of this man as soon as it's light.
Yes, sir.
Corporal Hawkins, you'll take the first watch.
Yes, sir.
Private Simmons, you'll relieve him.
Yes, sir.
Come on, men, let's get this fire out.
Thank you.
never thought was goners, Major. What'd you make them devils stop in like they did?
I don't know, Trooper. I don't think we better wait around here anymore and try to find out either. Let's pack up and get out of here.
Appreciate what you've done for me, Mr. Glass.
Forget it, boy. I'll be scouting ahead, Major.
Sam, you know the Apache better than any of us. Why do you suppose they quit last night?
Well, my guess would be they're having a little fun. When they get tired of the fun, then I think we better prepare for dying.
Trooper Hatfield, sir. Break out the shovels. Looks like we've got another grave to dig.
Are you sure we got time? I ain't looking to end up as buzzard bait. Let's hightail it out of here.
That's an order, Trooper.
Yes, sir.
I don't know what you thought of this man, Lord. I grew to like him the past few months. He was a bit headstrong, but that's the way of mountain men, I suppose.
Well, I'll be a son of a...
He can't last more than a few hours. I'm asking for a couple of volunteers to stay with him till he dies and bury him properly.
That's asking a mighty lot, ain't it, Major?
Oh, we know better than those savages we're running from. I'll see to it whoever stays gets double pay.
Ain't much need for money with your head splitting wide open from a tomahawk.
Under the circumstances, I'll forgive your insubordination, Jenkins. What's the matter with you men? I don't think there's one of us here doesn't owe a debt to Sam Glass for something. And what about you, Trooper? Where would you be now if Sam Glass hadn't sucked the rattler poison out of your neck that time? And you, Hatfield, who was it pulled you out of the muddy when the Apache shot your horse out from under you last spring?
I'll stay. Double pay, huh? That's a mighty tempting offer, Major.
You're volunteering?
Yeah, I reckon I am.
All right, the rest of you men, mount up. We've got 75 miles ahead of us of playing cat and mouse with Yellow Shirt. We'll move as slow as we dare. You men will probably catch up before nightfall. Come on, men. Let's go.
You think he's gonna last?
Too darn long to suit me.
Hey, did you hear something out there?
Shut your lip, boy. You're making me nervous.
Sorry, just thought I heard something.
You're gonna keep hearing things out there till you jump out of your hide.
Lim, what you gonna do with your extra pay?
I'm gonna get me a quarter rye. Yes, sirree. A quarter of that rot gutness rye you've ever seen. That's what I'm getting. Hey, boy, did I ever tell you about the time I caught myself one of them Blackfoot squaws? You know them Blackfoots, they're different than them dog-faced. They don't mind a white man throwed in every once in a while. For variety, I reckon.
You think if I gave him a drink of water, it might help to ease him a bit?
Must have got him, Major. Otherwise, they would have caught up by now.
Let's stop here for an hour or so and give the horses a breather. Maybe they'll catch up by then.
It's sure taking him a hell of a long time to die.
I don't see how the devil he can last much longer.
You stay here, boy.
I'm gonna take a look around. Them engines may be down our throats any minute.
Thank you. My dear Martha, I miss you very much. I know that I said I'd be home by now. But Major Henry promised me a bonus for this last trip. And it means that we'll have enough money to buy that little piece of ground that we've always wanted over on Spring Creek. I hope you like the music box. I picked it up at Sutter's store a couple of weeks ago.
Trooper Joe said he'd deliver it along with this letter. Tell little Sam he's to be a good little boy and help you with the chores. And tell my little Rachel that Papa will make a cradle for her dolly when he gets back. Martha, I know it's been rough on you and the kids, but we'll be together soon, the way a family should be. I love you, Martha. I love you very, very much. Sam, P.S. There's been no trouble at all with the Indians.
Thank you. Don boys with shimmering shoes of yellow on top of the sunbeams that stream toward us. They are dancing at the east. The rainbow moves forward. Dawn maidens with shimmering yellow shoes, shirts of yellow, dance over us, beautifully over us. It is dawning, beautifully over us. It is dawning.
Thank you. now.
Sam. Sam. I'm over here, Sam.
Where am I? I can't see you, honey. I'm coming home, honey.
Over here, Glass.
Over here, Glass. I'm glad to see you, boys. What took you so long to get here? My throat's dry. Real dry. I need water. Real bad. You wouldn't deny a man a drink of water now, would you, boys? Me, Sam. Don't you know me?
Look at me! I'm your friend! I'm your friend! We ain't friends no more, you can bet on that! You're yellow! The both of you!
I ought to leave you to the wolves!
You dirty coward! You ain't got the guts to stand up to a real man! Come back! Martha! Martha!
Thank you. mountains rising high. He was a gentleman and couldn't stand it, knowing he might watch his people die. They were a peaceful tribe, the Mescaleros, they'd chosen for the chief. A yellow-shirted legend running free, a man called she. The white man came along and broke the promise as they did at Wounded Knee. With trouble in his heart, this man called she fought to keep his land and people free. They've chosen for the